Let's talk about what a diagonal matrix is. A diagonal matrix is a square matrix. So n by n matrix A is called a diagonal matrix. If all the non-diagonal elements are zero, so that means if Aij is equal to zero for I not equal to j. So anywhere you find out that the element is not in the diagonal, all those elements have to be zero. That's what we mean by a diagonal matrix. What's happening on the diagonal has nothing to do with whether a particular matrix is considered to be diagonal or not, but what's happening in the off-diagonal elements. So Aij has to be zero for I not equal to j for all possible values of I and j. So let's look at an example. I'll take a 3x3 matrix here for an example of the diagonal matrix. Let's suppose 3, minus 2, 6, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So what makes this a diagonal matrix is not what's on the diagonal. These elements can be any number they need to be, including 0, but what's happening in off the diagonals. If you look at the row number and the column number of any of these elements, they are not the same. So for example, this is A12, this is A13, this is A23, this is A21, this is A31, this is A32. In all of these elements which you are finding to be 0, you are finding out that, hey, your row number is not same as the column number. So for every element for which the row number is not same as the column number, they have to be 0. In these elements where this is A11, A22, A33, where you're finding out that, hey, they are on the diagonal, where the row number and column number is the same, they can be anything you want, so, or they need to be. So let's take another example. If I have a similar matrix like this, with 3, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 6. This one is a diagonal matrix also, in spite of this second row, second column being 0, because the diagonal matrix is dependent on these three elements and these three elements for this 3x3 matrix, the ones where the column numbers are not same as the row numbers. And that's the end of this segment.